Welcome back to Sacred Rhythms. I'm really glad that you're here. Today we're going to be talking about the second of our Triduum services, namely Good Friday. Now, Good Friday is the most different of the three services. Well, that's not really right. They're all pretty different, each in their own way, from the Sunday service and from each other. But at Holy Trinity, Good Friday is the most different, because at Holy Trinity, we do Tenebrae. Now, there is a suggested Good Friday liturgy on page 138 to 143 of the LBW Minister's Desk Edition, which is the veneration of the crucified, which we don't do at Holy Trinity. Now, we did for about 7 years. We did, because we had a Roman Catholic musician who really hated Tenebrae, which Mike and I had done ever since we were ordained. He really hated Tenebrae, and he wanted to replace that service with a service of adoration of the crucified. So Mike and I said, fine. I mean, we do adore the crucified. And even though we loved what we did, you have to be flexible and you have to keep learning. Well, after 9 years, that musician left us. And the people said, oh, it's so sad. He's gone. Can we go back to Tenebrae? Which we immediately did. Tenebrae is what we do at Holy Trinity on Good Friday. And the whole congregation loves it and finds the entire service to be very devotional and very moving. Now, the first time that I ever saw a Tenebrae service was back when Mike and I were dating. And he invited me to his Episcopal church for their Good Friday Tenebrae. I had never seen one before, and I was absolutely blown away. This little Midwestern Lutheran had never seen anything like Tenebrae before. The emotional impact the first time you experience Tenebrae, I can't emphasize enough. In fact, I have never seen another Tenebrae except for the ones that Mike and I have led. We've researched it. And the first year we were ordained, we found an old SBH book of Tenebrae services for Holy Week. It was a little book, and it was intended to accompany the service book and hymnal. And we adapted the one for Good Friday. So we may be doing Tenebrae wrong, but it works for us and for our congregation. The first thing that you have got to do, though, if you're going to do a Tenebrae service, is you have got to explain to everybody what you're doing right from the get-go. We have this explanation all written out in our bulletin, so that nobody is caught off guard for very long, and also so that there isn't a lot of talky at the beginning of the service, because it really doesn't go with a Tenebrae service. We tell them that this is the office of Tenebrae, or the service of shadows, in these written explanation. This is the service of shadows for Good Friday. And the word Tenebrae is a Latin word that means shadows. It means darkness. The dramatic features of this service include the black draping of all bright objects, the gradual extinction of all lights except the Christ candle, and a loud noise at the end of the service. We tell them that the Lenten custom of veiling or draping the cross, the altar, the baptismal font, is intended to call the worshipper's attention to what we may have become so familiar with that we're taking it for granted, to focus our attention on the great essentials of Christ's work of redemption. And that would be the cross, the altar, and the baptismal font. The veiled cross focuses our attention on Christ's death for our salvation. He gave his body and blood so that you and I might receive forgiveness of sins, eternal life, and salvation. The veiled baptismal font focuses our attention on the God who claimed each one of us as his very own in baptism. On the day of our baptism, for the sake of the bitter suffering and death of his Son, our Heavenly Father claimed you, claimed me, as his own son, as his own daughter. He claimed you as his own, forgave your sin, and delivered you from death and the devil, and gave you everlasting salvation. So the veiling of the baptismal cross focuses your attention on that. The veiled altar focuses our attention on the God who comes to us anew every single time we receive the Holy Sacrament, every single time we receive communion. In this sacrament, the Lamb of God himself gives you his own body and blood to eat and drink. And he does it so that your sins might be forgiven, so that you might be given new life and salvation, so that you might receive eternal life and salvation. Throughout Lent, we tell the people the color of the veils is purple, the color both of our penitence and of Christ's royalty. On Good Friday, though, we exchange the purple for black, as a reminder that Jesus Christ alone is the light of the world. Without him, our lives would be lived in utter darkness. And that's the truth. We don't do it in black as a sign of grief or anything like that. We drape everything in black as a reminder that Jesus Christ alone is the light of the world, and without him, we would be in darkness. And having explained to them what they can see and what it means, we then tell them what to expect during the service. During the worship service, all lights are extinguished except the Christ candle in order to remind us that Jesus Christ is the true light of the world. The Christ candle is taken briefly out of the chancel to remind us that Christ was truly crucified. He actually died. And then in the darkness, there is a loud noise to remind us of the closing of the tomb and to remind us of the earthquake on Good Friday. And then we pray there in the darkened sanctuary. We pray the Lord's Prayer together. This is a very powerful worship moment. And then the Christ candle is returned back into the chancel in anticipation of our Lord's resurrection. And this explanation is given to the congregation for them to read in silence as they're waiting for the Good Friday worship to begin. And then the musicians and the pastors enter in silence, and we're off. We sing, Ah, Holy Jesus. We hear lessons, and we chant Psalm 22 before we hear the reading of the Passion according to St. John, the entire Passion. When we read the Passion, we use several members of the choir as readers. They each read a pericope. So many verses of it. We do not divide them up into parts. We don't do that. And we intersperse each of their readings with one verse of O Sacred Head Now Wounded. And this is the 7-verse version of O Sacred Head. And after the whole passion is over, we take a time of silence. And then after the silence, we sing Stricken, Smitten, and Afflicted as the hymn of the day. You who think of sin but lightly, take a look at what's going on here in the crucifixion. And while the congregation is singing Stricken, Smitten, and Afflicted, the choir processes right down the center aisle and then goes up to the balcony. And when she's done playing, Jackie goes upstairs. And then the tenebrae itself begins. The choir sings something meditative. One pastor reads part of a psalm antiphonally with the congregation, while the other pastor walks to one of the candles on the altar and snuffs it. And our man behind the scene turns off 1/7 of the lights. There are 7 candles on the altar. We have just snuffed out one of them. They are votive candles. They're in little red votive candle lights. It looks really cool. Then the choir sings a second meditative hymn. And the whole process continues until all of the 7 candles have been extinguished and there are no lights on anywhere in the chancel. No lights. No lights in the hall. No lights. And there in the darkness, the congregation prays together the Lord's Prayer. Powerful worship moment. And then the Christ candle is carried back into the chancel from the sacristy. The sound of the strepitus is heard. And then the Christ candle is brought back into the chancel. First, the Christ candle is carried out. Then the strepitus is heard. Then the Christ candle is carried back in. And the lights softly come up, reminding us that the light shines in the darkness and that the darkness cannot overcome it. We love Tenebrae. It is such a powerful worship service. I hope that Good Friday is good for you tomorrow. If you're a member of Holy Trinity, I hope to see you at Tenebrae. And I hope to see you back soon at Sacred Rhythms. And then I'll talk a little about Easter Vigil. Thanks a lot.